I left Sri Lanka when the civil conflict broke out in the early to mid 80s and migrated to Canada. My family migrated to Canada at that point, and I told myself at that point that I was going to make a difference. Even if it meant touching just one life, I felt it was worth it. I'm so thankful to the country that's adopted me, but also the organizations that have trusted me. In fact, Christian Children's Fund of Canada, when they gave me this responsibility to both lead and serve. As a CEO, I'm always excited when I go to bed knowing that the following day is going to be another opportunity for me to make a difference in the lives of the people we are called to serve. And that includes my staff, my colleagues, who are as passionate about the work that we do. I would like to see CCFC being part of an equation where we can truly say that our legacy was that we helped communities, we helped countries, we helped regions, where we worked with children and we actually helped children to raise their voice and to realize their dreams.
Looking forward to visiting Christian Children's Fund of Canada, Ethiopia office. We'll be meeting with Feleke and other colleagues. So this will be my very first visit to the office.
So welcome, and you have already introduced our staff.
One of the things that really excites me is our future. You know, there was a time when we would look at our country offices as primarily program countries. But now with this new concept of what we call shared leadership, you're as important in shaping our future as the office in Canada. And I don't want you to underestimate what that means.
We've been on the road for a couple of hours now and heading to our destination. Personally for me, I'm looking forward to learning more about some of the significant inroads we've made, particularly in the area of early childhood development.
Overall, it was a fantastic day, a huge sense of fulfillment in terms of what I saw, what I witnessed, but I think most of all what I experienced, particularly interacting with our children that we support and the children we are called to serve. One of the things that really inspires me is the fact that we are called to really just not work with children but also serve children as well. And every time I see a child or I see children, I see it as an opportunity just not to interact but also to remind myself the importance of the work that we do.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
We are very close to the village, and the villagers are coming on horses. This is an honor
for a big guest, what they are doing for a big guest now. They are accompanying us to take us to the village.
This small village is called Godino.
Look at the child.
Our partner Ratson, who had already given us a bit of context to the amazing work that's taking place. Again, our partners are critical in terms of the work that we do. We are very dependent on them to really reach out to our communities. And my sponsored child, Addis, actually belongs to this particular community here. So, having been welcomed by the community, I was given the opportunity to spend time with her and her parents and her family. Spent about good 20 to 30 minutes with her. And we talked, well, I did most of the talking, I have to confess. We talked anything from her schooling to her aspirations to how she feels about her community, her country, etc.
Each child has a promise, each child has potential, and each child has a possibility. I would like to see all three P's being realized in the life of a child. One of the things I would like CCFC to do is to be the catalyst to make it happen.